I've only been in this car for 10 minutes and my eyes are already drooping. While me and Daddy were talking about boring stuff and money, and it was hard for me to pay attention to much of anything. Mommy thought I would get bored, so before we left she had put on the SpongeBob SquarePants movie. I had already seen it 100 times and I could match up the words perfectly. I was far more interested in the fields we drove past and how they looked funny when we went fast. It looked like they were smashed together, but moving. We were on our way to drop me off at Grandpa's house for the weekend. Mommy and Daddy usually dropped me off for the weekends because they were busy and always said they didn't have time to take care of me. Sometimes they said they needed to do chores and stuff, even though the house was spotless. One time I asked Daddy about this and he said it was no fib, although I was smarter than that. I pestered him about it and he finally told me he wanted some time with Mommy. Mommy heard this in the next room and came shouting at me. I didn't do anything wrong, but maybe she didn't like me asking so many questions. I still cried myself to sleep that night. I took my earbuds out to play SpongeBob's voice and asked Mommy, "Mommy, are we there yet?" She quickly looked at me in the back of the road and said, "No, well, we left 15 minutes ago. Can you be patient and please watch your SpongeBob movie?" She replied. She sounded kind of annoyed. I slumped down in my seat, staring at my shoes. I kicked them back and forth slowly. I wanted to ask Daddy something, but it felt like he didn't want to be bothered either. I laid my head on the car door and looked back to the wintry fields. Maybe when I can drive, I'll drive so fast that I'll take off and start flying. I wouldn't want the field to look like then. I can feel my eyes getting heavy, which means I'm tired. Maybe I'll sleep the boring car right off. Mommy and Daddy's voices started to sound funny, but I didn't really care if things get dark. The warm feeling was on my cheeks, like I could hear someone calling my name. I didn't want to wake up, and I felt too good to sleep. I tried to ignore when they shook me and called louder, "Will! William! Wake up! We're at Grandpa's!" Opening my eyes, I was blinded by the light. The sun was out, and it was really bright and stuff. It kind of hurt for the first few seconds, but it got better. When I could finally see, we were outside Grandpa's big old shack, as he always calls it. Grandpa himself was sitting in his rusty old porch chair that he had since World War II or something. I loved seeing the huge house. It had a big parking area, and the house itself had like 1 million rooms. It looks kind of small from the outside, but it's funny to see how big it is inside. I hopped out of the car and walked into the grass. The grass was really green, and everything that Grandpa had a huge garden by the porch. There were a few trees here and there in the front yards and in the backyard, which I really, really liked. There was a beautiful tree near the back fence. Grandpa calls that an oak, which I told him that's the same name as Professor Oak from Pokemon. Grandpa shook his head at me and said something about not being up to date about what kids are into now. It's kind of funny how much he doesn't know. I think it's because he's so old. Grandpa waved us over and we talked on the porch for a bit. He said we should get something to drink before Mommy and Daddy left. Daddy told him that he really had to get going and he didn't have time. Grandpa just responded with, "Alright Robert, I guess I'll see you later." It was weird that he called Daddy Robert when his name was Daddy. I went to ask Daddy about this and he told me that that was his real name. I told him he was lying and he just laughed and roughed out my hair. There's this strange feeling I have, but Mommy and Daddy are kind of, not there. They seem like they don't care about much of anything. That's why I like coming to Grandpa's house, though. As though he was old and stuff, he still walked around being happy and whistly sometimes. Mommy and Daddy got into their car and backed out into the driveway, then down the road. Grandpa and me stood there and watched them drive down the winding path that was in Grandpa's driveway. When I couldn't hear the car anymore, Grandpa turned to me and said, "Ready to head in?" I nodded and we both walked through the big double doors of the White House. During my time I spent here, I had lots of fun doing different stuff. I got to play board games with Grandpa or watch TV or run and play outside. There was a neighbor I was friends with and sometimes he played around at her house. Or my house. Her name was Sally and she was really pretty. Some of the memories we had were the best. Playing hide and seek in the huge house was a favorite game. We never really liked going over her house because her mom was really loud and yelled a lot. Grandpa was pretty understanding what kind of home he came from, so he let Sally stay for dinner and stuff. I had got to Grandpa's early in the morning, so I didn't get much time to do anything before Grandpa called into the kitchen that lunch was ready. I was up in a room, and I stayed to the highest floor. I really liked this room because I could look out the window and see forever. I could see a huge yard up front, Sally's house and some other people's homes and all the trees everywhere. I could sit up here all day and just stare at the world. Grandpa's house was full of surprises. I could hear Grandpa's voice calling yet again. This time it was louder, which was enough for me to snap out of my daydreaming. I stood up and ran out of the room down the stairs. Jumping some of the steps always made me feel like a pro runner or something. I had fallen a few times, but it didn't bother me that much. I finally got down from the third floor and slid onto the kitchen on my stock. Perfect, I thought to myself, smiling a little. I ran and sat on one of the chairs at the kitchen table, and Grandpa gave me a plate with a sandwich and a cup of orange juice. He always knew just what to make. I sat there munching on my sandwich. I heard a knock on the door. Grandpa left the spot for the counter and went to go answer the door. I didn't hear anything after Grandpa left the room, but I was too involved in eating to care. Soft footsteps were behind me, and I thought it was just Grandpa coming back in the room. Then I felt something pushing on my chest. It scared me a little, and I threw my sandwich on my plate. Trying to grab whatever was on me, I could feel it was a pair of arms. Not big arms or hairy and old like Grandpa's were. They were soft and kind of small. Looking behind me, I could see a straight yellow hairy all staring behind me, hugging the chair and me. Hi, William. She hugged a little harder for a moment, then let go, backing up to give me room to turn around. She had a big smile on her face. Hey, Sally, what are you doing here so early? I asked her. Grandma was coming back from the living room, which was between the door and the kitchen and went down the hall. I heard the door open and close back there. I wonder why Grandpa always goes back there, but I'm doing something other than hanging out with him. I saw you come in with your mom and dad, so I thought I'd stop by. Don't want to waste the day, we gotta keep starting on fun things. He sounded like he was really excited. Alright, let's go play tag outside. We turned around to see a sliding back door to get to the backyard. It's not only playing with Sally that I like to see the bright green grass and a huge tree in the back. It looked really neat. We played tag for a while morning and left the yard for a good amount in the afternoon, and sometimes I could see Grandpa's head looking at us through one of the windows of the house. Even though I've been here for as long as I can remember, I could never find that room that Grandpa went in. I think it's the same room he kept looking at us through, which was kind of weird. I didn't pay attention to much of that. After hours of playing different games and running around, Sally and I were so tired that we went and sat by a big tree near the back to get some shade. We sat next to each other at the base of the trunk. The trunk of the tree always looked like something was splashed on it. I imagine that it was whatever made the tree so pretty, so I didn't really care. I went to sleep right there, but Sally kept talking about random stuff. I didn't want to be mean, so I listened to her. He stopped talking a bit and lay down, staring up at the leaves. I did the same on the other side of the tree. As I went to put my head down, I felt something on the back of my head. It wasn't very comfortable, so I tried to put my head somewhere else. My head once again lied on some object. I sat up and looked towards Leon. The second one was a rock, but the first one looked strange. I picked it up and held it on my finger. It was like a branch or something. Maybe, but it was kind of squishy. Whatever, it was about as long as one of my fingers, but a bit bigger. Part of my hair, whatever was hard. Only on a small part of it. I almost threw it, thinking it was poo or something. But then I remember Grandpa didn't have any pets. They stayed more. And with a huge fence around the yard, no animals could get in. It was covered with mud and dirt, so I really couldn't see what it was. At one end, it was all rough, and then something in the middle. It kind of reminded me of a William, Sally, come in and help some lemonade. Grandpa called in from the back porch. He had a different pair of clothes on than when I saw him earlier. I got up and went over to Sally to wake her up. She had been so tired he just fell asleep. When she opened her eyes, I told her to come on. She stood and walked with me to the house. I dropped the thing I found, not thinking about it again. When I asked Grandpa about his clothes, he said he had spilled some paint on them and he just wanted to get a new change of clothes. I look around, didn't see anything that had a new color on it, but I didn't really care. Sadly, I flopped down in front of the TV and started watching cartoons. Grandpa watched a little bit, but then he fell asleep in his big chair. I had seen these cartoons like a billion times, so I got bored. I started thinking of something else to do with Sally. A thought came to me, something I always wanted to know. I turned to Sally and asked her, "Hey Sally, you want to look around the house?" She looked as bored as me, but looking like she was too sure. "Why? We already see this house entirely, and we've seen every room. I don't know, it just sounds kind of boring." She turned back to the TV. "Not all the rooms." When I said that, she turned and looked like I finally got her attention. "What do you mean?" "I mean, you know that room where Grandpa always goes in when you and me are doing something?" "Yeah?" "Yeah, the room that Grandpa looks at us when we're out back." "Your point?" She sounded a bit annoyed. "Let's go find that room. I don't think we've been there, and it sounds totally awesome and mysterious." Trying to sound excited and make her want to do it, while also being quiet, so I didn't wake up Grandpa. He sighed and said, "Fine, there's nothing on TV anyways." He got up and followed.